Natural hazards and extreme events are incredibly important. They, particularly in a place like Australia where we suffer from them so badly, they leave scars. They leave scars on individuals. They leave scars on families, on communities, on our environment, on an economy. And these scars take a long time to heal. This is really important stuff. In some ways, a country like Australia is defined by these factors. There's a great poem by Dorothea McKellar which talks of Australia as a land of drought and flooding rains. It's a defining factor, a defining feature of Australia. And we can look at this and take the viewpoint of us as victims. So we're just a victim to these natural events, which are largely, in a sense, random. And that's a really disempowering thought for me. I much prefer the approach where we start to understand what's going on here, so we can predict them, so predict these events, so we can respond to these events effectively, both proactively before the event and reactively after the event, so we reduce those scars. I think it's really important also to actually be thinking about the sorts of things that we can do as individuals, at community level, at government level, where we can actually not only reduce the risk of these events happening, but reduce the consequence of these events when they happen, and do this in a way which actually generates other benefits. So, you know, improved environmental quality at the same time, improved water quality, etc. And so for me, these are things where we should be thinking in a very positive way, a very hopeful way, not dismissing the challenges they present to us, but thinking about how we can work with nature rather than against nature, work with each other rather than against each other, and cooperate so we actually make the world a safer place. There's all sorts of different types of extreme events. There's volcanoes and earthquakes, but then there's cyclones and floods and fires, hailstorms like we had in Canberra just a little while back, and many other types of natural hazards. And some of these are changing in their frequency and some of them aren't. So the ones that aren't changing in their characteristics tend to be your volcanoes and earthquakes. And that's because it's part of very long-term geological processes. The ones that are changing are the ones that we're influencing through climate change. So the cyclones and the storms and the hailstorms and the fires and those sorts of things. So when we actually look at insurance records, we see very little change in the damage associated with the volcanoes and earthquakes on average, but huge increases in the damage associated with those climate and weather-related natural hazards. And so they're the ones that we need to think about. How do we change what we do so that we don't experience unnecessary risk in the future?